Nicole Sandler show?
Yeah. Yeah. Is this the call I've been waiting for?
Yes. You might have heard of me. I am the brain worm on Robert Kennedy Jr.
Oh, you're the actual worm. I thought you were dead.
A lot of people think that, but actually what nobody knows, what we don't tell you, is that, you know, that hydrochloroquine that everybody were prescribing?
Yeah.
In horses, it's a dewormer, but in humans, it is like food. It's like a steroid. So I'm stronger than ever.
Oh, okay. So are you still inside RFK Jr.'s brain?
Oh, yeah. I've been there for a long time. I've been there at least since 2012. You know, and what people don't know is that I'm in charge of all of this stuff, you know, and I'm the one who makes the decisions. Like that whole thing with the bear, that was me.
Oh, the bear, the Central Park bear cub. So
that was
okay,
my idea.
Then let me
also
ask you
did
something.
You hear about the
whale.
About the whale head?
I heard about the whale head. So that was you too?
Yeah. So here's the thing is, everybody knows that whale blubber is like a great food, all right?
Okay.
And it also is something that in the United States, it was used for energy. And RFK Jr., extreme environmentalist, he cut off the head, strapped it to the roof of the car,
yeah,
and we drove back, and he was going to use it for, like, you know, lamps and stuff.
Oh, the blubber. Okay. But is there much blubber in a whale's head?
Oh, yeah. Well, there's plenty of blubber. You know, and also, what that stuff that they have that makes perfume out of that that's in the head? It's good stuff. It's ambergris. So what is that stuff?
I don't know.
They make perfume out of it.
Okay. If you say so, I don't know.
So I said, you can make some big money on this. And that's what he did. And, you know, this stuff is coming out now. It's like, but this is what I've been driving for a long time, is make it so that he is in charge of things. And did you just hear what's going to happen with him now with Trump?
What?
He was posted on the transition team. So I mean, Robert Kennedy Jr. is going to be in charge of picking who's going to be running the government for Trump.
So you, the worm in RFK Jr.'s head, are actually in control of Bobby. And so now you, or Bobby through you, has endorsed the former guy, and you, in, you know, controlling RFK Jr.'s actions, along with Tulsi Gabbard, will be running Trump's transition team if he wins.
Yeah, of course he's going to win. I mean, I was going to win, but I decided that, you know, I help him out, you know. By the way, do you know if Tulsi's got a brain worm as well?
I don't know, but the symptoms seem to be there. Well, maybe it's a female brain worm. You guys can get something going on.
Ask me. Ooh, that's exciting. The whole brain worm, like, you know, that's how it starts. It's like we mate and we go in the poop and then we go in the pig and then we go out in the body and the people touch the poop and the pig. Ooh, it's very exciting. But got any questions for me about who I'm going to appoint for various different things? I mean, who Bobby's going to appoint?
Sure. Well, first of all, I got to ask. Now, did you actually try to call Kamala Harris too? Because the reports are that Bobby tried to get in touch with her to offer her the same kind of deal he was offering Trump. You know, give me a cabinet position and I'll endorse you. But that Kamala wouldn't take his call.
I know. What a stuck up B-I-T-C-H. I mean, come on. I'm a Kennedy. I mean,
well,
he's a Kennedy. Yeah. Everybody takes a call from the Kennedys.
Okay, so you are the worm. Do you have a name or are you just worm?
Well, you could call me Dave, but, you know.
Dave the worm inside of Bobby Kennedy's brain. Okay.
And I have all the best policies, you know, like that. For example, I'm very much against solar power. You know why?
Why?
It's dark at night. No power.
I've heard that. So are you also against wind power because it's not always blowing?
Well, wind's a little bit different. I mean, you know, it's kind of like, you know, the wind blows. The real problem is you can't store that energy. It doesn't go anywhere. It just like it goes in the ground. And so somebody said, hey, let's put it in batteries.
Yeah.
But the problem with that is the batteries, they are made with rare materials out of China. So instead, what we need to do is store the energy where it's always been, in the ground. And you know what's in the ground?
Water.
Oil.
Oil. Oh, oil. I see.
Yeah. Yeah. It's already there. So that's what we're going to do. And the people, they say they're trying to make it so that we have environmental. What the thing is, sure, we can make things better here in the United States, but China, we don't want China to win.
Oh, so China's the boogeyman. What about Russia? Are you friends with Putin?
Of course.
Yeah.
You know what's best about Putin? He is the kind of guy who's going to be invading places that have lots of energy. Like, what's that one place that he invaded?
Ukraine?
Oh, yeah. Nope.
No?
No. Yeah, well, Ukraine. But, you know, that they got a lot of energy there. Yeah. That's what I heard.
Yeah, the nuclear. And I understand Putin's hitting the power grid now again.
Exactly. You know why?
Why?
Because those people, if they had solar power, they could keep going. But he's smart enough to know you go after the centralized power, like solar. It would be decentralized. That's why it's bad.
Okay. So Worm, Dave the Worm, you're running Bobby Kennedy's head. So now he and Tulsi Gabbard are co-chairs of Donald Trump's transitional committee. So who are you going to suggest? First of all, what about Bobby, you know, like replacing J.D. Vance on the ticket as the vice presidential nominee?
Well, there was a lot of talk about that, you know, but the problem is that he's got the money. You know, we got that. You got that Peter Thiel money. You got that Elon Musk money. All right. So what we're going to do is we're going to have him kind of like sidelined. Like that is like, so what we're going to send him to a bunch of places that nobody cares about. And then he'll talk and nobody cares. Then we're going to bring in somebody much more exciting.
Oh, more exciting than J.D. Vance?
Well, of course. Who do you think is the number one most exciting conservative person right now?
Gee, you got me on that one. I don't know.
Donald Trump.
But he's already the presidential nominee. Is he going to be both?
He can do both.
Okay.
I mean, think of it this way. If he dies in office, he can assume the role of himself.
But he'll be dead.
Details.
Or do you have the, you were dead.
Well, right. Maybe there's somebody in his head like me. I'm just saying.
Okay. Well, that's a possibility, I suppose. All right. So why don't you just put Trump in all the cabinet positions?
Well, we're going to do that. But what we're going to do is we've got a special guys in charge of this loyalty stuff. We really, really love the loyalty stuff. So, and he was the guy who was in the Pentagon. And I think he used to be Trump's body man, you know, the guy who like wipes his diapers and changes his diapers and wipes his butt. Okay.
Right.
And he was in charge of making sure people are loyal. He's like, are you loyal? And that guy is the one who's going to do it for all of these cabinet positions. So that's the first question we ask is like, are you loyal? We make them take an oath, you know, and it's like you have to eat a hamburger and fry, you know, with like ketchup. And then if they do, then they're loyal. And then like, you know, who's not loyal? The last person who's in charge of the transition. That was
Chris Christie.
Yeah. Mm. And, you know, Trump tried to kill him and it didn't work. So, which is kind of a drag. Anyway, so he's going to be in charge of all these transitions. And then Chelsea.
Tulsi. Tulsi.
She's going to be in charge of the military stuff because she's got a streak in her hair. And that means she's military.
Well, she did. She served in the military.
Yeah, that's great. Yeah, by the way, did you see that great photo op that President Trump had at the
Arlington? Yeah, I did. Now, how did that happen? Because he's not president.
Says you. So what he did is he talked to the people at Arlington and he says, hey, I'd like to do a photo op and a campaign stop. And they're like, well, you didn't say very nice things about the Medal of Honor and stuff like that. And he's like, hey, I'm the president. And they said, well,
no, you're not.
It says you. Okay. So what I did was I slipped some money, because that's the thing, is you're like, slip some money to the people who we're going to visit. And they just said they could do it. Now, a lot of people are saying it's not legal. I looked it up. As long as there's four people or less, they could go there. Unfortunately, he had six people.
Yeah.
So basically, we're going to get away with this, just like we got away with all that other stuff with the military. I mean, it's just, I'm not going to say suckers and losers, because it has been totally proved by what's his name? Gene Kelly, or what was the Walt Kelly, or what was that guy who's a general or something like that? He said Trump said that.
Right.
Which is totally factually correct.
Right.
But as we know, if you say it enough times, it's wrong.
Well, of course, we learned that. Hey, Dave, the worm inside of RFK Jr.'s head. I got a question about Bobby's wife. You know, Cheryl Hines, the actress. I get, you know, Bobby looks good for his age. Was she always crazy too? Is she an anti-vaxxer? Is she a nut job?
Well, this is kind of a bone of contention, not a whale bone, but just a bone. One of the things that we found out is that when you're really famous, people come after you and they like to like hang out with famous people. And then when they marry you, then they have to end up defending you until you go cuckoo bananas.
Uh-huh.
And then they have to like stay with you until the divorce proceedings are final.
Oh, are you telling us something? Is Cheryl Hines divorcing Bobby?
I'm not going to say, because she knows what happened the last time to the last woman divorced. So look out.
Well,
by the way, did you know that he moved the body of the last divorced wife like so that she could oversee the freeway? I thought that was great. Oversee the freeway. Not like she can't see it or anything, but he knows it would oversee the freeway. They just moved the body.
Is that like Donald burying Ivana, not Ivanka, Ivana, Ivanka's mother, at his golf course at Bedminster? Or does that have to do with like
the
secret
best
documents?
Tax move ever.
Yeah.
Yes. When you bury a body in a golf course, it no longer becomes a golf course. What it is a cemetery.
Oh.
And cemeteries are taxed much, much lower. I mean, this is the business genius
of Donald Trump. Great. All right. Hey, Dave, this has just been fascinating.
I'm happy to answer any more questions later. But what you want to make sure is people understand, solar power is bad because it's dark at night.
Okay. Yeah, we got that. And Donald Trump has said things like that. So it's fitting that you would think that as well.
All right. Have a great day. And remember, make America something again.
You know, Worm, thank you so much. Dave, the Worm, inside of Bobby Kennedy Jr.'s brain. Thank you, Dave. You know, it's really interesting that Dave called in to say that, because, you know, this whole